Thank you.
State, flags, left or right, face.
Divisions,
right,
face.
Sectionators, fall out and collect out of arms.
Forward,
march.
Divisions,
counter,
march.
Divisions,
halt.
Prepare for review. Admiral General Crossfire, Crossfire. Ready.
May I have your attention, please? For the remainder of the review, no one will be permitted to pass in front of the review stand. And we ask this as a courtesy to our reviewing officer. Photography is certainly encouraged, but we ask that you remain seated and off the drill deck. The photographers you will see on deck throughout the review are the official photographers of our crew, training, command.
Division commanders,
left. rain. Rest.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I am Lieutenant Peters, Recruit Training Command's Drill Division Officer. I would like to welcome you to today's password meeting. Today, you will see 10 divisions comprised of 662 sailors participating in a graduation ceremony and soon join the most powerful Navy in the world. Please draw your attention to the unit position at center deck. There is a review commander and staff. The review commander is responsible for conducting the graduation ceremony. Today's review commander is Seaman Recruit Luis Rodriguez from Orange City, Florida. Let's give him a hand, folks. Performing today is a staff unit on their 6 week of training. This unit is comprised entirely of recruits. During their night of arrival, recruits are placed in divisions of 88 personnel and assigned division commanders. Recruit division commanders form the backbone of recruit training and are key individuals in the life of every recruit. Division commanders must serve as counselors, disciplinarians, administrators, and military leaders. Above all, they must show themselves as outstanding examples of military bearing, appearance, attitude, and behavior. Each division also has a recruit chief petty officer. This senior recruit supervises the divisional staff positions and leads the division in the absence of their division commanders. Now, it is my pleasure to introduce the graduating divisions, their division commanders, and recruit chief petty officers. As I introduce each division, they will raise the competitive flags that they have earned throughout their training. Please hold your applause until all introductions are completed. I will be starting from there, right. Division 3, 2, 5. Command Officer, Chief Petty Officer, T.J. Wilhite. Petty Officer First Class, Benito Nunez. Petty Officer First Class, Peter Bowen. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Brock Olson from Marshfield, Missouri. Division 3, 2, 6. Command Officer, Chief Petty Officer, Michael Cooper. Petty Officer, Second Class, Angelica Lago. Petty Officer, Second Class, Paul Piriano. Petty Officer, First Class, Ryan Lincoln. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Austin Jones, Pendleton, Indiana. Division 3, 2, 7. Command Officer, Chief Petty Officer, Edison Miller. Petty Officer First Class, Cody Cassidy. Petty Officer Second Class, Jacob Dale Payne. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Trevor McManus from Arlington, Virginia. Division 3, 2, 8. Commander, Petty Officer First Class, Justin Alvarado. Petty Officer First Class, Juan Luca Capetta. Petty Officer First Class, Zylona Perry. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Brayden Foster from Taylorsville, Georgia. Division 3, 2, 9. Command Officer, Chief Petty Officer, LaVon Harrington. Petty Officer First Class, Robert McKenzie. Petty Officer First Class, Nicholas Williams. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Devontae Tolles, Gulfport, Mississippi. Division 3, 3, 0. Command Officer, Chief Petty Officer, Lenta Sylvester. Petty Officer First Class, Roberto Santana. Petty Officer First Class, Oscar De La Rosa. Petty Officer First Class, Brendan Williams. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Angelica Diaz from St. Croix, Virgin Island. Division 3, 3, 1. Command Officer, Chief Petty Officer, Shannon Robinson. Petty Officer First Class, Bob Lines. Petty Officer Second Class, John Bartlett. Petty Officer Second Class, Marcus Broomfield. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Brandon Lopez from Bullhead, Arizona. Division 3, 3, 2. Commando, Chief Petty Officer Carlos Ferrer. Petty Officer First Class, Clarissa Garcia. Petty Officer First Class, Elias Sandoval. Petty Officer First Class, Harry Porter. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer Senior, Kristen Ferrar from Murfreesboro, Tennessee. Division 3-3-3. Commando, Chief Petty Officer Cody Martinez. Petty Officer First Class, Jordan Rich. Petty Officer First Class, Donald Goodman. Petty Officer Second Class, Gabriel Powell. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Ryan Link from Chesapeake, Virginia. Division 3-3-4. Commando, Chief Petty Officer Timothy Taylor. Petty Officer First Class, Reginald Carr. Petty Officer Second Class, Angel Zunino. Petty Officer First Class, Ellis Gonzalez. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Andrew Upchurch from Flower Mound, Texas. On behalf of the Command Office, Staff Recruit Chain Command, we congratulate these Division Commanders and the Recruit Chief Petty Officers on a job well done. This time our tradition is our formal greeting to this morning for viewing officers. When requested by the announcer, please stand for the right arms, marching on the coast, the national anthem, and the invocation. As a reminder, military guests shall be covered throughout the entire graduation ceremony. And ladies and gentlemen, one final note. As with any importance of this occasion, our ceremony is conducted in a formal manner. However, we do encourage you to participate in today's graduation ceremony by letting your applause show the sailors just how proud of you are. Once again, welcome aboard.
Will the guests please rise and remain standing for the arrival of the official party? Recruit Training Command, arriving.
Arms. Freezing. Arms.
Sir!
Captain Brooks will now present this week's individual awards, and he'll be joined on the drill by our commanding officer, Captain Sam. Seaman McNally receives a letter of commendation from the commanding officer. Well done, sailor. Seaman Nolan is presented with a commemorative plaque and a letter of commendation from the commanding officer. Well done, sailor. Seaman Troy Rendon, Division 327, from San Diego, California, is the winner of the United Service Organization Award for best exemplifying the spirit and intent of the word shipmate. Seaman Rendon is given a commemorative plaque from the United Service Organization. Well done, sailor. Seaman Andrew Lloyd, Division 327, from Cedar Rapids, Iowa, is the recipient of the Military Order of the World Wars Award of Merit. This award is presented for meritorious performance during crew training. Seaman Lloyd is presented with a commemorative plaque from the Military Order of the World Wars. Well done, sailor. The Military Officers Association Leadership Award is presented to Seaman Apprentice Wilberto Vega Pedrosia, Division 334, from Aguadillo, Puerto Rico, for demonstrating exceptional tenacity and professionalism. Seaman Apprentice Vega Pedrosia is awarded a letter of commendation from our commanding officer. Well done, sailor. Seaman Robert Zuniga, Division 327, from Austin, Texas, is the recipient of the Navy Club of the United States of America Military Excellence Award for best exemplifying the qualities of enthusiasm, devotion to duty, military merit, and teamwork. This award places him at the pinnacle of today's newest sailors. He is awarded a flag letter commendation. Seaman Zuniga, the staff of a crew training command, salutes you as the finest of this group of graduates. Well done, sailor.
Division.
It is appropriate to recognize
recognize such outstanding individual accomplishments by these sailors with a round of three cheers. The Agit team will lead all graduating divisions in three cheers for this morning's award winners.
This important mission became imperative after the COVID pandemic began. You were additionally entrusted with maintaining a safe training bubble as COVID-19 spread, and you performed in an outstanding manner. Through many long days and nights, you put service above self. Put simply, today's ceremony and all those done over the past 16 months would not have been possible without you. I know we don't have a lot of families in the audience today, but normally I would say for the families that are here to give a round of applause for the staff. So since we don't have any guests in the audience, I'd ask the entire RTC staff, please give yourself a round of applause on the job well done. And to our dear sailors, you are now part of an impressive history. For over a century, Naval Station Great Lakes has transformed more than 3 million civilians to highly trained sailors. The program here has always been rigorous, demanding more from you than you probably thought possible. Each of you has answered the call to duty, serving a cause greater than you as an individual. You have passed battle stations and proved yourselves worthy of wearing the uniform that symbolizes freedom throughout the world, the uniform of the United States Navy. The Navy offers you endless opportunities to excel both personally and professionally if you're willing to work hard. As you embark on one of the most challenging and memorable adventures of your life, I have an important message for you. Do not forget about your family that helped you get where you are today. Your family will live vicariously through your adventures, so keep them up to date and make sure you call them on a regular basis. You've chosen to serve your country at a time when it's most needed. When America must show its strong presence throughout the world, on and below the seas and in disguise. I'd like to close with a quote from George Washington. He said, "It follows then as certain as that night succeeds the day, that without a decisive naval force, we can do nothing definitive, and with it, everything honorable and glorious. Sailors, your service will ensure our Navy and our nation remain strong. Thank all of you for taking on the responsibility of defending our nation. You have earned not only my respect, but also the respect of a grateful nation. I wish you fair winds and following seas as you begin your Navy journey. Bravo, Zulu sailors. Well done."
Thank you.
Thanks again to each and every one of you for joining us on this most memorable of Navy Days. RTCs, take charge of your divisions to carry out the plan of the day. RTC staff in the north and the south garage doors will be open momentarily. If you would please exit out of those. Thank you and enjoy the rest of your day.